I remember looking at those glasses and thinking, how am I ever going to paint those? Hi, I'm Sara and I make art. In this video, I'm going to show you how I finished this portrait, with particular emphasis on how I painted these glasses. The trick to doing this right is to have a lot of water or mixing medium mixed into your paint. I have a glob of zinc white on my palette. I'm spritzing water into it, mixing it up with my palette knife. I decide it's not the right texture, so I'm spritzing it down again, mixing it again, and after the second time of spritzing and mixing it, then it looks right to me. Squirt, spritz, mix, check it, spritz, and mix again. I'm using my liner brush because I want these to be very subtle, and the liner brush is the only brush small enough to do that. If I used a brush that was any bigger, even the round brush, the paint would spread out too far when I blended it. Now here's the part where I thought I messed up because I realized I wanted the lens to be down lower on her face than it was. But I realized all I had to do was paint a streak in that place where I wanted the bottom of the lens to be, and that's what I'm doing here. I don't know if I already mentioned this, but I can't have any harsh lines here, so I'm paying extra careful attention to my blending. I wanted the part between her eyes to be lighter, and this might be kind of lazy, but I just glazed some zinc white over that area to lighten it. Again, I'm making sure to blend out the edges. With the same brush and the same paint that I used to paint the little, I don't even know what you call that thing that is between your glass lenses. With the same color that I used to paint those, I'm painting the rims on the top of the glasses. I'm painting this part of her frame with burnt umber and oxide black. I'm painting this top part of her frame here. I actually made the line too thick to begin with, so I'm going over it with a damp brush to correct that. I had burnt sienna on this part, but I realized it really needed burnt umber. I decided to paint Adelaide's eyelash, and I mixed up a pretty similar color to the color that I used to paint her hair, which was a grayish yellow with some purple mixed in. I just made it a bit darker. Then I realized I never gave her any eyebrows, so I'm painting those in too. And I'm painting the other eyebrow now. And just like I did with Katie's, I'm making sure this brow extends all the way out to the very edge of her eye. If you watched last week's video, you'll know that I ran into a bit of difficulty with Katie's eyes. Well, I still wasn't happy with them, so I went over them again with some ivory black, and I really think it took down even more of that creepy glow that was in them to begin with. Honestly, painting the glasses was so easy, I almost thought, I don't even have a video to make. I thought it would be encouraging for you to see that sometimes painting something really is a lot easier than you think it's going to be. Since you watched this video on how I painted glasses, you might like this video I did about how I painted the eyes that are behind glasses. And here's the finished piece. I make videos with art demos and tips every week, so if that sounds good to you, please subscribe and let me help you bring out your creativity.